It's banned in Britain, where the film board condemned its casual sadism and unrelenting focus on stalking and brutal slaying.
Literally teach our children how to kill and maim and hurt people.
To drive over pedestrians, to kill police officers, to attack women.
They are arguably the best teaching tool we have.
Hey, what's everyone talking about? I'll give you a hint. It's the same thing that's defining our generation. This is my documentary. Let me take you back to 1985. Nintendo, a Japanese playing card company, has come up with a revolutionary idea, the Nintendo Entertainment System, or NES for short. Prior to the NES, household video games were just a silly fad that was constantly wavering between hip and yesterday's news. Gaming consoles couldn't keep up with the graphical capabilities of arcade games, leading to subpar console games. The NES became such a hit because its games not only matched the arcade games, they surpassed them. While the graphics were an improvement, at the same time they were very basic and used plain bright colors instead of real textures. Because they were so colorful, everyone assumed that they were for kids. For a short amount of time, video games and controversy didn't belong in the same sentence. A business is nothing without its competitors. Another Japanese electronics company, Sega.
Sega!
Yes, that's Sega, decided that they wanted a piece of the American video game market. In 1989, they released their own video game console, the Sega Genesis. This created the first ever console war. While Nintendo declined to sling any mud at Sega, Sega did not hide their contempt for Nintendo at all. Their slogan was, Genesis does what Nintendo don't.
Genesis does
16-bit arcade graphics.
You can't do this on Nintendo.
The main difference between Nintendo and Sega was censorship. While Nintendo refused to allow any mature themes, Sega embraced them. Sega had many controversial games in its lifetime, but none more so than Mortal Kombat. With its graphic violence, it appalled critics, baffled parents, and charmed the hearts of millions of children. Mortal Kombat made many people realize that video games were not just child's play. While Mortal Kombat is not the first violent video game, it is the first violent video game to draw attention to itself. The creators of the game spent over $10 million on an advertising campaign that declared the release day, September 13, 1993, Moral Monday. This over-the-top campaign was a success, earning the top spot on many a child's wish list. The widespread knowledge of the game reached Connecticut Senator Joseph Lieberman. Senator Lieberman was outraged by the graphic violence in Mortal Kombat. Senator Lieberman was even more outraged when he discovered how popular the game was with young children. Lieberman decided that he had to do something. On December 1, 1994, the video game industry was changed forever. Senator Lieberman and the popular children's TV personality, Bob Keeshan, held a press conference concerning violence in video games, namely Mortal Kombat. Lieberman felt that a standardized rating system would help stop the creation of violent video games.
We now require warning labels on toys that can potentially damage children's bodies. Why not do so on a toy that can damage their minds?
He then announced that in 1 week he would hold a hearing in the Senate for all the big figures in the American game industry. Senators Herbert Cole and Byron Dorgan would be joining Lieberman. The world waited anxiously, anticipating this momentous occasion. It seemed that each party in the hearing had a different solution to the situation at hand. Howard Lincoln from Nintendo of America was not in favor of a rating system. Nintendo thought that censoring the violent video games would be much more effective.
We're really deceiving ourselves that we're going to keep this kind of violence out of the hands of children.
Bill White of Sega of America felt that a standardized rating system was not necessary because Sega already had an in-house rating system. You see, Sega tried to die down the Mortal Kombat controversy by hastily making a rating system a mere 5 months before the meeting. Sega believed that the VRC, as it was called, was adequate. Congress did not agree.
But doesn't have the word mature attached to that?
Yes, I believe it does.
And so the presumption is those over 13 years of age are mature?
Yes.
Are you kidding me?
Senator Lieberman wanted the new standardized rating system to be created by the industry. He believed that it would be more constitutional this way. So he gave the video game companies 3 months to create a universal rating system. If they did not meet the deadline, the federal government would rate the games themselves.
Hearing is adjourned. Thank you all.
After months of deliberation, the video game companies, collectively known as the Entertainment Software Association, unveiled their new universal rating system, the ESRB. The ESRB started out with 5 ratings. Early childhood is the lowest rating. Games that receive the early childhood rating are mainly educational games. An example of this rating would be Dora the Explorer, Journey to the Purple Planet. They are suitable for ages 3 and up. The kids to adults rating is the exact equivalent of the E for everyone rating today. Games that receive this rating are squeaky clean with no or minimal violence. Examples of this rating are Super Mario Galaxy and Little Big Planet. They are suitable for ages 6 and up. The T for teen rating is for games that are suitable for ages 13 and up. Teen games can contain more serious violence, suggestive themes, blood, and light profane language. Examples of this rating are Super Smash Bros. Brawl and Uncharted 2. The M for mature rating is for games that are suitable only for ages 17 and up. These games contain intense violence, large amounts of gore, sexual themes, and strong language. Examples of these games include Halo and Grand Theft Auto 4. The final rating is extremely uncommon. The adults-only rating is for games with graphic nudity and extreme violence. All the major stores have policies against selling adult-only games, which discourages developers from making them. I obviously cannot show clips from any of those games. You may notice that I did not mention the Everyone 10 and Up rating. That rating did not come into existence until 2004. Games with this rating have content somewhere between E and T. Congress accepted the ESRB. A universal video game rating system was finally created. However, was the hearing in the Senate a success or a failure? Like most things in history, the result was a mixed bag. Senator Lieberman did accomplish his goal for a universal rating system, but at the same time, it didn't work out the way he hoped. He thought that by making a rating system, violent video games would be extremely uncommon. It actually did just the opposite. Violent video games became extremely common and accepted because now there was a legal classification for them. Every year, games seemed to be getting more violent, to the dismay of Lieberman. He, along with Hillary Clinton and Arnold Schwarzenegger, are still fighting against video game violence, so many years after the original debates. The only people who can consider the hearing a success are the video game companies themselves. No matter how much controversy follows them, the video game industry is still one of the most profitable industries in the world. The debate proves that this once fad is definitely here to stay.